Doc, you better back up. We don't have enough road to get up to 88.
Roads? Where we're going, we don't need roads.
If there's anything that movies have taught us, it's that if you have access to a wormhole, a souped-up 80s sports car, or a questionably sanitary hot tub, you can pretty much punch your ticket to travel through time and space. But before you go jetting off to the future to find out who wins the World Series, or back in time to invent the internet, or to kill someone's mom to ensure a victory for the machines over the human race, there are some things you need to know. Every time travel movie stretches the genre with different answers to questions like, what is time? And how does time travel work? So to make things easy, we've broken time travel into three theories. Theory 1, the multiverse timeline. Time is made of alternate dimensions and parallel universes. The 2009 Star Trek movie utilizes this rule. Spock's actions in a universe where Captain Kirk is hunky with smoldering eyes does not affect the universe where Captain Kirk is, well, William Shatner. Both universes exist equally. Theory number 2, the dynamic timeline. Time is flexible and evolving. This theory is also known as the butterfly effect. One small change can impact the present and the future. The rules of this theory will cause existential contradictions, known as the grandfather paradox, where if a man goes back in time and kills his grandfather, he would cease to exist. But if he were never born, how would he have time traveled and then killed his grandfather in the first place? Existential contradictions aside, in Back to the Future, Marty McFly breaks this rule by interfering with his parents hooking up. His existence is compromised. So now if he wants to exist, he has to play wingman for his dad. Theory number 3, the fixed timeline. Time is predestined. As a time traveler, your role in history was always to go back in time, creating a continuous loop. In physics, this is known as the Novikov self-consistency principle. Is there a grandfather paradox? No. In this theory, when the grandson goes back in time to kill his grandfather, he will not be able to do it. The gun won't fire, or some other hand of fate will intervene to prevent the grandson from killing his grandfather. In Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, Harry and Hermione use the time turner to go back in time to get some information. Their actions do not cause any new events. It's all over recursive loop. As for time itself, experts remain divided. Some say it's linear, like a VHS tape.
You may have to travel back in time to learn about one of those.
That plays forward. But time travel involves rewinding the tape and erasing everything to that moment, creating a new history. Some say time is not linear, that the past, present, and future exist all at the same time. So, taking into account all these theories, contradictions, and paradoxes, the best explanation may be from Jeff Daniels in Looper.
This time travel crap just fries your brain like an egg.
Which time travel theory do you believe in? What's your favorite time travel movie? Let us know in the comments below.